For the first 22 years of my life, I was a scumbag. One of the worst. The worst thing about it is I thought I knew what I was doing. When I was 9 years old, I walked the aisle and I was dunked in the water. The bad thing about that is I was just following everybody else. We were at a revival in a little church. I said the things I thought people wanted to hear as I went to high school. I drank, I did drugs, and I chased girls, which is completely contrary to what God says and everything that I learned in church because my parents took me to church every Sunday. I was a fake. I was the worst kind of sinner, the one that had a form of godliness but denied its power. Went through high school, the end of my high school, I met a girl who eventually ended up being my wife, and I treated her the same way. I still went out and drank. I still did drugs. The only thing that changed is I didn't chase women. God had sent me a gift. I didn't recognize it as that. I just recognized it as somebody that was with me. And my wife and I had moved down to Central Texas for a little bit, and it seemed like a good escape. I didn't have to worry about people telling me to go to church or to go do this or go do that. We went to church a couple of times, but I never really felt comfortable about it because Satan had a big enough hold on me that I didn't need to worry about that. I could hold my alcohol and I could do whatever I wanted to do because we were on our own. No parents, no family around. While we were there, we lost our first child. Mitzi became pregnant and miscarried. And looking back today, that was the best thing for that baby, was to go back home with Jesus. Because she didn't need a dad like me. So money wasn't that good down there. We were just kind of, as they say, living on love. And I decided one day that we were going to, I was going to move back to West Texas. So I came up here, started looking for a job, got a job with my brother-in-law in the oil field. One weekend, my brother told me, "Hey, why don't you go to church with us? We have a new pastor, and just see what you think." Nobody in my family knew me that well. They didn't know what was going on in my life. You know, my brother invited me, so I went. And that Sunday, he was talking about the very type person I was. It was a clear presentation of the gospel, and it's like he was talking to me. It wasn't a white-knuckle ride where I was trying to keep from getting out of the pew. I went just as straight as I could go. God had showed me my sin, and I was broken. So that Sunday, when I was 22 years old, I accepted Christ. I knew then, I knew that power, because that power is what got me out of that pew and up to the front and on my knees before God. I called my wife that Sunday and told her what had happened. We got here, we got involved in the church, we got things situated, we both joined the church together as a family, we got to rocking. In that time, in probably the next year, God had called me to a work of evangelism, and that's just kind of where it kicked off from there. And I'd like to say that our life was rosy after that, but Satan put us through hell. I've probably been attacked more since I became a Christian than I ever have in my first 22 years. But the thing I know is the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. And that's all I have to hold on to. And my wife has gone through a coma in which they told her she was going to die. Both my kids' health wasn't good when they were born. But through all that, God watched over us and took care of us. There were times when I wondered what he was doing, but I just had to have faith in how he took care of us. Now he's got me in a place where I get to tell kids all the time about Jesus, whether the government likes it or not. I enjoy my life. People go, "Well, what do you do?" And I tell them, I said, if I'd have known I was going to have this much fun, I would have done it a long time ago. Because where most preachers look to be in a church or whatever they're going to do, I really enjoy where I'm at. And God blesses me and my family for that. I pray that he continues. I pray that my faith and my hope stay strong in him, and that my family just keeps growing. Today I have 2 kids, 4 great-grandkids fixing to be. My kids love the Lord, and I hope someday they get to lead their kids to the Lord as I got to lead them. I'm Jeff McElroy, and that's my story.